Tushar TV, Sandy Base is a lot from Sandy Base India. Tushar.
So, sir, your experience till now at India?
And just starting only, we have just gone through all the presentation and all. This is nothing to tell about. I should ask you, you should ask these things after the end of the event. Ambience is nice. Hospitality is good. I will say the infrastructure of facility that you have provided are like not at par the quality we have been accepted. We have gone through the other organization like for the EMA also. And all these things like you have provided is much less. And you are putting up these three guys from the corporate just to go through all the calculation and to accommodate at least three laptops.
There should be a table at least that should accommodate at least three laptops. Three guys are going to work on three different things. We should be able to remove duplicacy among the other. So one should work on another. So we all require the laptop to be like there.
Okay. Apart from that, everything is good.
Right, ambience is good, hospitality is good, the breakfast was good, and even the faculty what they have told us about India and everything.
So the next thing I will ask, what are the factors or what are the skills that you see in an MBA aspirant like your freshman? You will be coming to institute. So what the skills are? What are the skills that you are looking forward for an MBA aspirant?
For MBA aspirants to have, to work in the corporate events like that.
For the success they will be getting in corporate. Tips for them.
Okay, you want our suggestion to you, guys?
So it's like, one should have a clear idea, as if like the theoretical world and the practical world is all together entirely different. So one should have a practical, how is going to go with that child? Like, not necessarily that every time whatever you're going to study or whatever you're going to do in life case studies, you'll be able to replicate that in the reality world. You might have to sometimes do wrong, you might have to sometimes do above your pay grade works and everything. So how is going to go with that? He should have a idealistic plan, ready to, he should be ready to face the situation because initially everyone is great, every junior is great.
See, the major world is changing tremendously. Every day the new technological advancement is there, and it's required every time. In fact, a few years back we used to have long term planning for 15 years or 10 years. Nowadays, a 5-year planning is a long term planning. Every 6 months things are changing. You have seen in the we are from the power sector. And you have seen recently 2 years the whole scenario has been changed and been shifted to the renewable. Once 2 years back, these solar panels, all the companies were moving towards the bankruptcy just because of the India towards this NHRM initiative. It isn't moving like anything. We say the VUCA world, it's volatile, uncertain, complex, and ambiguous. You have to be ready for each and every challenges. That's all. And you have to throw you for achieving all the goals that organization demands.
What is going to add to our organization? Like we already see, if you talk about NDBC, we have a huge pool of talent. What is the new thing or what is his vision that he is going to add to NDBC? Supposedly you are an interviewee, come on, tell me, what are you going to add to NDBC, then what would be your answer to that?
My answer would be my ideas, so it would be helpful for organization. Different thinking from others in a situation
there
should not be nothing generic. If he's coming to a power sector company, he should have a certain knowledge about power sector. If an engineer is coming to it, there is always an existing technology that power is being produced. So I don't expect him to bring an altogether new technology. But from the existing set, what else he can add upon it?
Yeah.
There should be at this current scenario, one should have a practical knowledge and everything also. It's not only a bookish knowledge that he is coming and learning all the models and everything. See, I'm a finance guy, so I don't expect him to know. Obviously, he has been reading, so he might be more updated upon the accounting standards than what I am.
Yeah.
But how is going to deal with it? How is going to deal with the practical? If I'm taking a power sector interview, he should know what's the cost of a power plant and how he's going to financially manage it and everything.
Thank you.